Alright, ladies and gentlemen, my name is Ivan, welcome to my channel. Today we're going to be continuing in our saga of amplifier constructions with a simple Class A amplifier, which we're going to be building today. Here she is on a breadboard. Looks good, let's see if it sounds good. I've got my speaker connected over here through a little choke and a large capacitor. My audio input is going to be from my phone, and it goes to this green jumper wire and this blue jumper wire. The blue jumper wire goes to the ground, and the green jumper wire goes over here to this capacitor. So without much ado, let's turn on the amplifier and let's give it a quick test. Okay, our power supply is connected, our amplifier is on. Let's do the sound test. So yeah, that's a little credence right there. Okay, now as much as I love Creedence, unfortunately, due to YouTube copyright protection, I can't show you anymore. However, what I can show you is how to build this circuit. And if you want to find out how to build this circuit, stick around, stay tuned. Okay, the schematic is pretty straightforward. It consists of a single MOSFET-based Class A amplifier driven off a single rail supply on 24 volts. Here's a circuit set up on the breadboard in all its glory. Now, the main differences in my circuit and the schematic are the following. Firstly, for my current source, unfortunately I didn't have a 15 ohm 40 watt resistor lying around, so I improvised and I used a light bulb. Now, this light bulb is a 12 volt, come on, let's just let it focus. Yeah, so it's a 12 volt 20 watt light bulb, nothing fancy. Bought this one in a pack of 6 for like 3 euros, so nice little light bulb. The next difference in my circuit and the diagram is I'm not using the 47 kiloohm potentiometer on my capacitor, so for my audio input. Instead, I'm using a simple 2K2 resistor, which works just fine, as I personally prefer having only one volume control, and that is on the device. Since nowadays all devices already have a built-in volume control, and I think it makes life a lot easier. So I removed that potentiometer and I just replaced it with a 2K resistor, actually a 2K2 resistor. The next difference in my schematic, actually in my circuit and the provided schematic, is that this capacitor over here, unfortunately I didn't have a 4700 microfarad capacitor. So I just went with this 1000 microfarad capacitor, and I skipped on the 1000 microfarad, the 10 microfarad capacitor as well. But again, it works just fine with this too. Next up, I'm using a 47 kiloohm potentiometer, as unfortunately I didn't have a 100 kiloohm potentiometer, and I'm using a 4K7 resistor instead of a 1 mega ohm resistor, as my transistor has a slightly larger gate capacitance than the 2SK1058. Therefore, for stability, I'm also using a smaller capacitor instead of the 33 microfarad on the diagram. And as for the transistor itself, I'm using this. Let's just let it focus. W20NK50Z transistor, so also N-channel MOSFET. It can actually take a bit more current and a bit more voltage than the 2SK1058, but again, pretty much any MOSFET will do for this, along with any variation on the components provided within this diagram, as a MOSFET is a voltage controlled device and they are pretty robust. I mean, as long as you don't put too much voltage on the gates, so for this one, as long as you don't exceed 30 volts, you should be fine. And given that my power supply is 24 volts, and this shouldn't happen, so it's a pretty much a foolproof design. So let's plug her back in. Now, Despite the circuit being functional and working, unfortunately, it's got some limitations. The primary limitation being it's a Class A amplifier, and unfortunately, it's on 100% of the time, meaning there is always current flowing through our light bulb, which is over here, and it's always on. This means that the circuit is most efficient when full load current is drawn. And unfortunately, that doesn't always happen, so the efficiency is quite abysmal of the circuit. That said, it still works, and it's a good circuit, really. So in order to adjust the circuit for optimal operation, what has to be done is this potentiometer over here has to be slid until the gate threshold voltage is reached, at which the relative resistance of this MOSFET will be equal to the resistance of the light bulb, therefore creating a 1-to-1 potential divider, and the voltage will be sandwiched at half the supply voltage. So for 24 volt supply, this will be around 12 volts, as that is when there's going to be the optimal sound output. Although this value may depend for the MOSFETs which you are using, for me I found it to be about halfway on this potentiometer, but keep in mind it might depend on the potentiometer being used. Okay, so now that we know how the circuit looks, works and feels, let's do a quick harmonic analysis just to see what it's capable of, and to see how clean the output really is.
Now that we've got the circuit wired up and ready to go, let's measure the total harmonic distortion. So the way we're going to do this is I've got a 500 Hz source connected to my input, and I'm going to turn it on right now. So it's on, it's about 3/4 volume from my phone, and the circuit is connected. So right now, the voltage on the source of the MOSFET is around 22.4 volts. So let's adjust the slider until the voltage is going to decrease. So when the resistance of the MOSFET is going to decrease, because more current is going to flow through it, the circuit hopefully should reach a more optimal operating position, and you should see a waveform appear on the screen. I'm going to turn this potentiometer until hopefully we're going to reach a value where there's going to be a stable waveform without any clipping. So I'm going to set it to around, well, let's say 13.2 volts, which is fine. So as can be seen, let me raise my trigger. That's a really clean sinusoid. Let me just raise my amplitude. So yeah, that's about where clipping starts. So that's about, let's say, a little more than 20, no, let's say 15 volts peak to peak, so that's pretty good. I'm just going to turn off the amplifier a little bit, because this gets really hot. Because unfortunately, Class A amplifiers aren't the most efficient, due to the 100% conduction angle. But, as can be seen, they're pretty darn clean. So let's do one more thing, let's do a fast Fourier transform and measure the distortion. So I'm going to go to math. Let's go to... Nope. Okay, let's go to FFT. Measure. Alright. Let's lower the position of the FFT. That's too much. Let's go to... So yeah, 2.5 kHz. Let's raise the amplitude. Well, where'd you go? Let's raise the position a little bit. Let's go maybe 10 decibels per division, which is pretty good. Okay. So there's the circuit doing nothing. Let's connect up the circuit and play the sinusoid. So before we do that, actually, let's do a comparison. So this is the waveform coming from my phone, just raw. Let's turn up that amplitude a little bit. Alright, so there's that 500 Hz. There's that spike, it's pretty clean. There's a little bit of a harmonic right here, but I mean, it's not bad. Okay, so let's connect this over here, and let's turn on our circuit one more time. So as can be seen, that spike's quite a bit bigger. Okay, that's where we get our harmonics. There's a little bit of a third harmonic over here. But I mean, it's pretty good, it's well behaved. So, very, very clean. So yeah, as can be seen, my words are not hollow, and the amplifier is indeed pretty clean. But unfortunately, there is a lot of energy wasted in the form of heat due to poor efficiency. And this is going to require the use of a larger heatsink. In fact, a good improvement to this project will be mounting it on a permanent fixture and using a large heatsink with a ventilator, as well as essentially putting on a circuit board to decrease any parasitic capacitances to decrease that noise floor even further, allowing some really clean output. In fact, in the next video, that's what we're gonna do. Thank you for watching. Hope you enjoyed this video. Please give me a like, share, and subscribe. And see you soon in the next part. Take care.